Hey everyone, I hope all of you are doing great. So in this lesson, we are going to learn how to monitor websites using Prometheus, and then we are going to create a beautiful dashboard in Grafana. So let's try to understand or break down everything into three parts. First part, we are going to configure Blackbox, and then in second part, we are going to configure Prometheus, and in third part, we are going to create Grafana. So you may install Blackbox on the same server where Prometheus is running, or you may install Blackbox on a different server. So in my case, I'm going to install Blackbox on this server, which is the same server on which Prometheus is running. So in order to install Blackbox, we first need to download Blackbox, and for that you can go to prometheus.io/download, scroll down, search for Blackbox exporter, and then depending on the operating system, select the software which you want. So in my case, I have downloaded this Linux AMD. After you download, you need to uncompress it, then you'll be seeing Blackbox exporter directory, which you can see here in this case. And then once you go inside this directory, you can see by default we have blackbox_exporter, and then there is going to be a configuration file which is going to be called blackbox.yml file. Now I have changed that. I have created a new file which is called monitor_website.yml file, and in this file I'm going to keep the configuration. So now let me show you what is the configuration which we have kept here. It is pretty straightforward, okay, and all of this is beautifully explained in the documentation of Prometheus documentation. So if you go to github.com/prometheus/blackbox_exporter and then scroll down, and you can see all of these steps are mentioned here pretty beautifully. So what we need to do is these are the changes which we need to do in Prometheus configuration. We'll come to this, but before this we can see an example of the configuration which needs to be done in Blackbox side. So I'm just going to open up in this documentation in the new tab, and here you can see it's a complete example which has been given here. So I have just copied the one which we need. So we are just going to be discussing about HTTP response things. So that's why we just need first 8 lines. So I have copied these first 8 lines, and I have created a new file which is called monitor_website, and I have pasted those 8 lines here. Okay, so that's pretty much installing Prometheus Blackbox and configuring the configuration file. Now once these two things are done, we need to configure Blackbox service file. And as I shown you in previous example, that how we can create the service file for Prometheus, or we created it for node exporter. Similarly, you can go ahead and create a file, a blackbox.service file, and paste this here. So in this one, if you just see here, in the execution start, we need to give blackbox exporter complete path, and then in the config file we need to give the config file a complete path. So the new config file which I have created is called monitor_website.yml, which is this file. So once you create the service, after that you can reload the service by doing sudo systemctl daemon reload, and then we are good to start Blackbox service. Okay, so you can start Blackbox service by writing sudo systemctl start Blackbox. Now once we do that, and then we can also check for status of it. So we can write status, and then we can see that Blackbox is running. Now we need to do some of the changes in on Prometheus side. So as I shown you, we need to do two things on Prometheus. We need to update the Prometheus configuration file, and also we need to then restart Prometheus services. So why we need to change Prometheus configuration file? The reason for that is that now we need to tell Prometheus that it should start scraping a Blackbox related data as well. So that's the reason we need to modify Prometheus configuration file. So I'm just going to go back and going to go to Prometheus directory. And let me clear the screen and do ls-lrt. You can see we are at this location, and here I have Prometheus .yml file. And here the changes which we need to do is all also mentioned in the documentation. So if we go back again to GitHub, and here we can see in Prometheus configuration, so you can copy everything which is available here, and then you can paste it here. Okay, just remember one thing: if you already have scrape configuration, which is which you can see in my case, then from here you don't need to copy this scrape config line. You can just copy the remaining lines, or you can copy everything and then you can delete this scrape config line in your editor. So in this case you can see it is pretty much I have copied everything from here, and then in the website, in the targets, these are the websites which you want to monitor. So I have just added few websites which I want to monitor. You can add more websites. So for example, let's say if you want to monitor some other site, like I'm going to add instagram.com. I know in your production environment, it is not going to be some public website. It is going to be, you know, some of the enterprise a website which you might be interested to monitor, or some of the web application in within your organization which you want to monitor. So you can give URL of all of those sites here. Now remember one thing, in the module name you need to give the module name which you have given in the black box configuration file. So here this is called http://example, and if I just save and exit, and if I just go back to black box configuration file, just to show you, you can see the name is http://2xx_example. So just make sure in the Prometheus configuration file you give the exact same name, otherwise you might face some issue. So now here you can see we have given the complete list of websites which we want to monitor, and then you can just scroll down, and in the replacement you can see here you need to give the server IP address and the port where you have installed a black box exporter. So in my case, since black box exporter is also installed on the same server where Prometheus is running, so that's the reason I have given localhost :9115, but in your production environment you might be having a separate server for black box, so you need to give that black box server's IP address and port. And now you can save it, we can restart the services, and I'm going to check the status again just to make sure everything is running fine. Okay, so you can see Prometheus is running. So now we have black box running and Prometheus running. So all of these configurations are done. Now we are going to move on to Grafana and we will start creating dashboards. So let me go back to Grafana. Now I'm going to add a panel, and we are going to add an empty panel. I already have a query which I need to paste here. So this is the query which I want to see. I want to see whether all of the website is returning HTTP status code of 200 or not 200. So by 200 it means it is working fine, and any non 200 code means it is not working fine. So this kind of data is best suited to be seen here in a table. So I'm going to select table, and also we need to make sure in format we change from time series, we change it to table. Now you can see we have changed it to table, and also we need to enable instant so we always see the latest data. And now here you can see the response code which is being returned. So anything which is having value of 200, it means your site is up and running properly. And anything which is returning non-200 codes, it means you need to see what is the meaning of that code. So for example, you can just see here HTTP response codes value, and here you are going to see your status code in HTTP. So you can see that all of these different status code is having different meaning. This is, I think, just having few codes, but in actual there are more codes which are available. So anyhow, we know that 200 means okay. So what we can do is, on the right hand side, if you just scroll down, there is an option which is called value mapping. So we are going to map this value, and we are going to say when a value is equal to 200, it means it is okay. And also when it is okay, I want to change the color to green, so we are just going to select green here, and then we are going to say add a new value mapping, and in this we are going to specify range. So we want anything between 0 to 199 to be shown as not okay, and we are going to also show it in red color. And then we are just going to create one more mapping. I'm going to show anything which starts from 201 to 600. I guess our range ends around 500, but just I'm gonna give 600 for safer side. And this also is going to be not okay, so I'm just gonna change it to red, and then you can click on update. And now you can see that rather than having status code, these values have changed to okay or not okay. Now one thing, if you want these colors to take effect in this case you can see that color is not taking effect. Now the reason for that is we need to change this cell display mode, and we need to change it to color text. So now you can see we are able to see green color or red color depending on whatever we have set here in this value mapping. Now this looks fine. I'm just going to rename it and then going to click on apply. So we know we have now information about this, and probably some of these details are not required, so you can go on and edit it. So we can hide this non-wanted column, we can hide time, and also we can hide name and job. So in order to do that, we can go to transform, and then we can search for we are going to search for filter by name, and here you can see all the fields. So I'm going to hide time, I'm going to hide name, and also we don't need job, so we are interested in instance, and we are interested in value. Now we can click on apply, and this is how this is going to look like. Now, other query which I have is going to give us whether whether it is using SSL or non-SSL. So let me just go on, and we are going to click on add new panel again. We are going to write this query here, and then we can see the kind we can see the data here. So what I'm gonna do is, again, I'm going to go ahead and use table, and then we are going to change this time series to table. We are going to enable instance, and now you can see anything which is having value of 1, it means the SSL is working on that. Anything which is not having value of 0, it means SSL is not working. Okay, basically it didn't give us SSL response. Now what we need to do is, we will do the mapping again. So we are going to go to value mapping again. I'm gonna go to add new mapping, going to go to value, and 1 means SSL. And also, if you just want to give some color coding, you can do that. And then if value is 0, it means no SSL. And you may want to highlight it again depending on your need. So in this case, I just did it. And also, again, we can go to cell display mode and change it to color text. Or if you want to change it to color background, you can do that as well. So I'm just going to change it to color text. It looks quite okay. And I'm going to go to transform, going to scroll down, going to go to filter by name, just going to remove time. And now we can say, we can call it SSL. So now you can see, now we are able to see data related to website status, and also we are able to see whether these sites are having SSL or not. Now there are a couple of more queries which are available which you may run. So for example, here we can see how much time it has taken to perform different actions. So for example, if I run this query, let's see what is the output which we receive. So for example, I'm gonna go to add an empty panel, and the data which it is going to give is going to be okay, that we use time series for that. So here you can see this is the kind of response which we are getting. I'm just going to narrow down the window from last 6 hours, I'm gonna narrow down to last 15 minutes, and here you can see basically different response. So for example, different response for different operations. So for example, you can see we have different operations like connect, processing, resolve, TLS, and transfer. And this is showing how much time is taken for all of these operations. Now what we can do is, let's get rid of this phase. So I'm gonna use phase, and then we are going to see only the phase labels. We are not going to see phase string. And then I'm going to enable table. And also, if you just want to show some value, for example, you might be you might want to show max value and also min value, so you know how much is the max and min time is being taken for each of these different types of operations. Now let's just save it. I'm just going to give it name of HTTP duration, and then we can click on apply and save it. So now you can continue exploring it and continue creating more queries here depending on your need. But this is pretty much it. This is how you can use Prometheus and you can monitor your website. And if you have any more questions, feel free to ask me. So that's all in this lesson. See you again in the next lesson.